Good morning, students. So yesterday we have started integers in IIT syllabus. What are called integers, children? The set of positive numbers and set of whole number, negative numbers along with zero are called integers. Or another definition, the set of whole numbers along with negative numbers are called integers. What is the symbol of integers, children? Capital I or capital Z. Okay. Next, what you learn? Representation of integers or number line. Okay, zero right side numbers are positive numbers, zero left side numbers are negative numbers. Okay, next, negative numbers always less than the zero and positive numbers. Positive numbers always greater than the zero and negative numbers. Okay, so the number line, right side of the number are greater. The number lies on the left side of the number are lesser. Okay, ma'am. Next, absolute value of an integer. See the page number 47. Absolute value of an integer. The absolute value of an integer is the numerical value of the integer regardless of its sign. It is the distance of a number on the number line from zero, without considering the direction from zero to the number lies. The absolute value of a number is never negative. So what absolute value never be negative. The absolute value of zero is zero. That's why we can't say that the absolute value of a number is positive, since zero is neither negative nor positive. Okay. So what is the absolute symbol? This is the absolute symbol. And also this one also called as what. What do you call this one? Mod or absolute symbol. Suppose we have to take in the middle A. How can you read this one? Absolute A or mod A. Okay? Absolute A or mod A, you can read like this. See, if A is an integer, then absolute value of A is denoted by mod A and is defined as mod A is equal to A if A is greater than 0. Mod A is equal to A if A is greater than 0. That is positive number. Mod A is equal to 0 if A equal to 0. Okay. Next. Minus A. When it is minus A, if A is less than 0. If A is less than 0, then the number is negative. So already we know the number, we know the number line. Zero right side numbers are positive numbers, zero left side numbers are negative numbers. So if it is A is greater than zero means positive integers. Okay, so that is A. Next, mod A is equal to zero when A is equal to zero. Next, mod A is equal to minus A when if A is less than 0, less than 0 means what are the numbers after less than 0? Negative numbers. So that's why minus A. Did you understand today? A is greater than 0 means positive integer. A is equal to 0 means 0. And A is equal to mod A is equal to minus A means if A is less than 0. Less than 0 means negative numbers. Okay children, did you understand? Let us draw examples. Example C. Mod 3. What is the mod 3 value or absolute 3 value? It is A, it is greater than 0 or not? It is a positive number. Yes, it is greater than 0. So what is the answer? 3 only. Suppose if I am taking minus 3. Mod minus 3. What is the value? Minus 3 is a less than 0. Less than 0 means negative number. So minus A. So minus of A. Minus of minus A. How much minus of minus? 3 is the answer. Did you understand? Mod minus 3 is equal to minus of minus 3. Minus of minus plus 3. So A is equal to minus A means how you can write? Minus A. Did you understand now? Minus of minus 3 mod like this. How can you write this, sir? Minus. Minus 3 value how much? Minus of minus 3. That means minus minus of minus plus 3. Here minus of plus minus 3 is the answer. Did you understand, children? Next, you have to do the operations also. Minus mod 3 plus of minus mod 3. How can you write this one? Minus of mod 3. So, what is the minus? Mod 3 value is 3. Plus minus of 3 mod. Minus 3 mod minus 3. What is the value? Plus 3. So, minus 3 plus 3 how much? 0. Did you understand now? Next, fundamental operations on integers. What are the operations? Addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. First one, addition of integers. Addition of two positive integers. The sum of two positive integers is always a positive integer obtained by sum of numerical value of and added. That means you should take any two positive numbers. Sum of two positive integers, that means 3 plus 5. This one is positive integer, this one also positive integer. So answer also positive integer only. 3 plus 5 how much? 8. 8 is a positive integer or not? Yes. So sum of two positive integers is always positive integer. Okay, ma'am. Addition of two negative integers. The sum of two negative integers is always a negative integer obtained by taking sum of numerical values of addends. That means you can take any two negative numbers. Minus 2 plus minus 5. This is negative integer. This one also negative integer. How can you do this one? Minus 2 plus of minus minus 5. Minus 2 minus 5 how much? Minus 7. Minus 2 minus 5 how much? Minus 7. So the sum of two negative integers is always negative integer only. Did you understand? Sum of two positive integers is positive integer. Sum of two negative integers is negative integer. Okay. Next. Addition of positive and a negative integer. One positive integer and one negative integer you have to take. For adding a positive and a negative integer, we first find the difference between the numerical values and assign the sign of the integer having greater magnitude. So, if you take one positive integer and negative integer, then add, what will get the answer? Suppose minus 4 plus 3. One negative integer,
positive integer.
Okay, one negative integer and one positive integer you should take. How you can do? You can do subtraction only. 4 plus minus 4 plus 3 how much? 1. Minus 1. Why? Because here negative term is bigger than positive. So that's why we should take minus. Suppose 4 minus 3. Okay, 4 plus of minus 3 like this given means 4 plus of minus how much? Minus 3. 4 minus 3 how much? 1. Why? Because here negative number is, positive number is bigger. That's why I'm taking plus 1. Did you understand, children? Which one is bigger? That magnitude you should write. Here minus 4 is bigger. So that's why I'm writing minus. Here plus 4 is bigger. That's why I'm writing plus 1. Did you understand, ma'am? So, if you take one positive integer and negative integer, you can add, you can do the subtraction, then which one is the bigger magnitude that you should write. Did you understand, ma'am? Come on. Next. Next topic is subtraction of integers. So, before we are going to subtraction of integers, did you understand, ma'am, this one? Next, subtraction of integers. If a and b are two integers, then a minus b is equal to a plus of minus d. Okay, shall we go to examples? Minus of plus 7. Large is given is how you can do. This is a positive integer. Minus and it is positive integer. Okay. So 5 minus of plus. How much minus of plus? Minus. So 5 minus 7. 5 minus 7. How you can do? You can subtract 7 minus 5. How much? 2. But here which one is the greatest number? 7 is the greatest number. Okay. So 7 having which one? Which sign? Minus sign. So you should write minus 2. Did you understand, ma'am? You can subtract 7 minus 5. 2. But here which one is more? 7 is more. So its symbol is minus. So you should write minus 2. Did you understand, ma'am? 7 minus 5. 7 minus 5 how much? 2 only. Why? Because here bigger number is positive number. Okay. So positive number means 2. Okay. 7 minus 5 how much? 2. Did you understand, ma'am? Next. Minus 6 minus of minus 6 minus of minus 8. How can you do? Minus 6 minus of minus. How much? Minus of minus plus 8. Minus of minus plus 8. 8 minus 6. How much? 8 minus 6? 2. Why? Because here bigger number is 8. 8 having what is the symbol? Plus. So plus 2. Did you understand that? Next. Another example. 0 minus of minus 10. 0 minus of minus 10. So 0 minus of minus how much? Plus. Plus 10. 0 plus 10 how much? 10. 0 plus 10 how much? 10. Okay, ma'am? Did you understand today? Did you know this one, amma? Plus of minus plus. Okay? Minus of minus plus. Like that you can do. Okay, we will get. Next, multiplication of integers. The process of repeated addition is called multiplication. Okay, so 2 into 3. How can you write this one? 2 plus 2 plus 2. How much? 2 plus 2, 6. 4, 4 plus 2, 6. Okay, so negative numbers is there, means how can you do? 8 into 53 into minus 125. 8 into 53 into minus 125. First you should multiply these two. Okay, we will get answer. Then you should, that answer you should multiply with 125. Okay, so here negative is there. Minus you can take. Okay, what is the answer? Minus will get answer. Did you understand, ma'am? So note, see here, the product of two positive integers is always a positive integer. So if you take any two positive integers multiple, you will get answer positive only. Okay, ma'am. The product of a negative and a positive integer is always a negative integer. So the product of a positive integer and negative integer, what is the answer? 2, 3, 6, here minus is there, minus 6. So, one positive integer, one negative integer, you should multiply. What is the answer? Negative will come. Did you understand, ma? You can multiply with one positive integer and one negative integer. The product is negative integer. The product of two negative integers is always a positive integer. Suppose see, minus 2 into minus 3. 2, 3 is how much? 6. Minus into minus? Plus 6. So, if you take any two negative integers, the product is positive. If you take any two negative integers, the product is positive. Did you understand now? See here, multiplication of signs. Plus into plus, plus. Plus into minus, minus. Plus into plus, plus. Plus into minus, minus. Minus into plus, minus. Minus into minus, plus. Okay? Plus into plus, plus. Plus into minus, minus. Minus into plus, minus. Minus into minus, plus. Okay, ma? Did you understand? So these are the multiplication of integers. Next one, division of integers. The process of repeated subtraction is called division. The process of repeated subtraction is called division. So let us go examples. How much? 12 divided by 4. How can you do? 4, 3 is 12. What is the answer? Quotient 3. Okay. If you divide two positive integers, the quotient is positive. If you divide two positive integers, the quotient is positive. Okay. If you divide two negatives, if you divide two negative integers, the quotient is also positive. Okay. If you divide any two negative integers, the quotient is positive. If you divide one positive integer and one negative integer, the quotient is negative. If you divide one negative integer and one positive integer, the quotient is negative only. Did you understand that? Did you understand that? The product of two the quotient of two positive integers is positive. The quotient of two negative integers is positive. The quotient of one positive and one negative is negative. The quotient of one negative and one positive is negative. Okay, ma? Did you understand? See here, note, in case of division of two integers, when they have opposite signs, the sign of division is negative. Here, see, opposite signs are there. Here positive, here negative. So, what is the quotient is negative. Here negative and positive. Quotient is negative. Okay. So, different signs are there. Different signs are there means quotient is negative. Same signs are means the quotient is positive. Here positive, here positive. Quotient also positive. Here negative, both are same. Quotient is positive. Signs are same means the quotient is positive. Signs are different means the quotient is negative. Did you understand, children? This is our topic today, class. Any doubts in that?